divide, and write the answer as a mixed number. And we have 3/5 divided by 1/2. Now, whenever you're dividing any fractions, you just have to remember that dividing by a fraction is the same thing as multiplying by its reciprocal. So this thing right here is the same thing as 3/5, as 3/5 times. So this is our 3/5 right here. And instead of a division sign, you want a multiplication sign. And instead of a 1/2, you want to take the reciprocal of 1/2, which would be 2/1. So times 2/1. So dividing by 1/2 is the exact same thing as multiplying by 2/1. And we just do this as a straightforward multiplication problem now. 3 times 2 is 6, so our new numerator is 6. 5 times 1 is 5. So 3/5 divided by 1/2 as an improper fraction is 6/5. Now, they want us to write it as a mixed number. So we divide the 5 into the 6, figure out how many times it goes. That'll be the whole number part of the mixed number. And then whatever's left over will be the remaining numerator, the remaining numerator over 5. So what we'll do is take 5 into 6. 5 goes into 6 one time. 1 times 5 is 5. Subtract, you have a remainder of 1. So 6/5 is equal to 1, is equal to 1 whole, or 5/5, and 1/5. And 1 and 1/5. This 1 comes from whatever is left over. And now we're done. 3/5 divided by 1/2 is 1 1/5. Now, the one thing that's not obvious is why did this work? Why is dividing by 1/2 the same thing as multiplying essentially by 2? 2/1 is the same thing as 2. And to do that, I'll do a little side, fairly simple example, but hopefully it gets the point across. If I were to take, well, let me pick, take 4 objects. So I have 4 objects, 1, 2, 3, 4. So I have 4 objects. And if I were to divide it into groups of 2, so I want to divide it into groups of 2. So that is one group of 2, and then that is another group of 2. How many groups do I have? Well, 4 divided by 2, I have 2 groups of 2. So that is equal to 2. Now, what if I took those same 4 objects, 1, 2, 3, 4. So I'm taking those same 4 objects. Instead of dividing them into groups of 2, I want to divide them. I want to divide them into groups of 1/2, which means each group will have half of an object in it. So let's say that would be one group right there. That is a second group. That is a third group. I think you see each group has half of a circle in it. That is the fourth. That's the fifth. That's the sixth. That's the seventh. And then that's the eighth. You have 8 groups of 1/2. So this is equal to 8. And notice, now each of the objects became 2 groups. So you could say, how many groups do you have? Well, you have 4 objects, and each of them became 2 groups. Each of them, I'm looking for a different color, each of them became 2 groups, and so you also have 8. So dividing by 1/2 is the same thing as multiplying by 2. And you can think about it with other numbers, but hopefully that gives you a little bit of an intuition.